What's that?
I'm so bad at it in golf, like putties and golf.
Oh, okay. Are you guys chilling or? Okay. Okay. Alright. Okay, well, what we're doing is we're all going to Chipotle right now, and then right from Chipotle, we're going to go to Boondocks. And Frankish called. And so he said he might meet us at Boondocks.
Man, Jim is getting her nails done. It's
Boondocks
been
is like 15 minutes south of, like, Layton. And it's just like this big game place. There's like go karts and like mini putt and shit like that. Yeah, it's like yeah, south, yeah. Like Farmington and like towards Salt Lake.
Sunlight shining over me, my eyes are open now. I see the stones been rolled away.
His life, so.
Gotta clash, man. Gotta clash.
Got the beautiful scenery and we're just clashing.
Mm-hmm. I'll take you to the basement. Actually, let's go see the dog first. The dog gets me pumped up. Jamie got a new puppy and it's adorable.
Oh, hey, Marley. You're not as cool. Lucy! Oh, there she is. Come here. Lucy, what the heck? Okay, this is Luce. Come here, Luce.
What kind of dog is it?
It's a boxer. Hey. Oh, yes. Can you bring it? Miley, what are you doing? Oh. Well, this is the basement, which is pretty nasty. Gene got us set up good. We got the legend on the wall himself. Yeah, and then this is just where we just get set up and play PS4 and chill with my puppies.
Thomas Hargrave and Chandler Watson have their first day off since training camp started over 2 weeks ago. But that doesn't change how their morning starts. Waking up, going downstairs, and playing PlayStation.
Are you killing it or what?
Not doing too bad.
What's that door clue in?
Man, they're slowly responding.
I know, man, they're so slow.
Yeah. So, it's a work in progress.
With nothing else to do, Watson and Hargrave invite some of their teammates over to go out to lunch and then go to an amusement park called the Boondocks.
Where's, all the kids?
The boys.
The boys.
There's not.
Oh,
I got you this. I forgot that. It smells good in here.
Yeah. Where are the puppies at?
Right here, man.
Look at these things, Scarlet.
Aww.
Perfect. Oh, this little guy.
Right here.
Oh, wow.
You can do anything to her. That's why she's awesome.
A baby. Hold her like a baby. Hold her just upside down.
What's up?
Yeah. Like she's so cool.
Miley's my girl.
Yeah.
Thanks, buddy.
Miley's like my wife.
Did you grab your cord last night, too, or is it still there?
I got that, yeah.
What are you doing?
She likes anything.
You can get lots of girls with that dog, eh?
Honestly.
Yeah. Let's go get some.
So who else is coming to hang out today?
I don't know, I'm texting Mons, but he didn't reply.
He's probably still snoozing.
I know, and Chazy is dealing with his skate, so.
What?
Watson and Hargrave enjoy boasting about all the awesome stuff their billets do for them.
Yeah, G's got us set up pretty nasty. And they got the knots, popcorn, you know, for the boys when we have movie nights.
Yeah.
We got our lounges. Fruit snacks.
Hiding his servers.
Chandler doesn't need my servers. And then, got these. And we got a fridge full of buys and stuff. I actually had it set up all online, but I'm a pretty dirty kid. I mangled it.
And some then yogurt.
Our frozen section. Gene's got us all pre-made cookies.
Wait for these.
Pre-made cookies already. Unreal, man.
And some pogos.
And we got the boys. Yeah.
Corn dogs are called pogos in Canada.
Pogo. So I just had a corn dog.
What is wrong with you?
You had a pogo.
Man, Canada's way better.
You guys got problems.
Man, you want to try my address?
Say America.
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 It's America.
Man, here, I'll go.
We don't say America.
Here, one sec. I'll
you
grab
call corn
my...
dogs corn dogs.
I'll grab you my...
What is the pogi? What is the reason for...
I have no idea.
Alright, so around it is like a cornbread.
Yeah.
And then you have a hot dog.
I know.
So it's a corn dog.
I don't know. And pogos are the things you jump. You know,
yeah.
Yeah. I don't know, when I got to Shattuck, it was just, boom, that's what I had to learn. We're having corn dogs today, and I was like, what the f***?
Pogos?
No, you're having pogos. Man. I don't know, what did Tom go get?
I don't know.
He's pretty heated in our Canada America Day.
Come on, mom.
Oh,
come on,
yeah, there we go.
Matt, have you ever had these?
Try these, and then tell us.
Have you ever had these?
Yeah.
So what? Do I just open it?
Yeah, you can. Man, this is Canada and in a cookie.
I'm so ready.
Those are fire.
Man, it's Canada and a cookie.
Dazzle. Oh my god. I could eat a bag of these.
I know.
Man, man, they're nasty, eh? They're so good.
Cause these are sick.
Yeah.
Yeah.
These are sick.
My all dress chips are so
cool. They're trash can down.
Broke out the all dress chips.
Holy cow.
Man, those are a prize possession.
After a fun yet pointless argument about Canada versus America, the boys are finally ready to go get lunch. Chandler Watson gives one more teammate a phone call to ask him if he wants to meet them at the Chipotle or meet them at the Boondocks.
What's that? Oh, okay. Are you guys chilling or? Okay. Okay. All right. Okay. Okay, well, what we're doing is we're all going to Chipotle right now, and then right from the Chipotle, we're going to go to Boondocks, and Frank gets called, and so he said he might meet us at Boondocks.
Man, Gene is getting your nails on, it's
Boondocks
been
is like 15 minutes south of, like, Layton, and it's just like this big game place. There's like go-karts and like mini putt and like that.
A little guy came up with you.
Yeah, it's like yeah, south, yeah. Like Farmington and like towards Salt Lake.
Alright, I think it's all clean now. You want your change?
Oh, the change machine! You mean you got a loony in here, pal?
Yeah, I do. You want your change?
Oh, the change machine! You mean you got a loony in here, pal?
Yeah, I do.
Man, we
good?
Need. Can we have this? Can I have it? Oh, you got two loonies, man.
I got a couple. But I've only been to Canada, and I haven't been in Canada in like 4 years. Alright, yeah, tell me where I'm going, though.
Yeah, just go straight.
Hey, put your seatbelt on, Chancellor. We're in America, not Canada.
Yeah, get it right.
Get it right.
All right, where are we going?
I took a Randy.
That's like a Larry's.
Yeah.
No, Larry's a lefty.
I'm aware.
So you're an out. All right, from Cali Music. They don't like that.
Who
are
you honking at?
You know where we're going. You good?
Yeah, I know how to get the Chopo.
Okay. I just hit my, I'm a little closer than normal. I'm trying to give you some room back there.
It's when I move the seat up to drive.
Yeah. My legs are a little cramped. What kind of music should we play?
Oh, when you hit the lights here, take a rando again.
Alright.
Yeah, rando.
Just throw in your country music, you know?
This music's so good, Cal. And this dude's good.
I'm picking a song.
Right, take a Larry at these lights.
Take a Larry? A Larry? Are you sure it's not a Roger?
No, there's a Larry.
It's Rando.
Joe Pope Bomb. Oh, this guy looks like he loves his Chipotle. Alright, Chaz.
Chaz Michael Michael.
Chaz Michael Michaels. That's what I named him from, man.
Chazler.
Laser. Really?
Chaz Michael Michael.
Chaz Michael Michael. Phone down. This is my team. Good thing you got a case on it now, though.
Man, I've dropped it like 13 times Laser. In the last 7 hours.
I know. I forgot we were sitting somewhere you dropped like you. 6 times.
Yeah, man.
Days.
I did it last night.
And block
the Pinto, please.
Oh, hi. Can I just get a chicken burrito, please?
Yeah.
No. You can tell no if you want to.
Would you like white or brown rice?
Brown rice is fine, thank you.
Black or pinto beans?
Not a fan. I mean, I'm not going to eat those.
So no beans?
No beans, please. Well, I'll take some veggies.
All right.
Thank you. That one.
Good luck.
Awesome. Thank you. Thanks, guys.
Maybe you guys get chips.
So I'm not a chip guy, I'm just a burrito. It's like the eating babies.
Those are all lame.
Eating babies.
Is your back so sore?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, you really can't get much better than that.
Yeah, these are the boys, so I mean, sure.
Nashville and Canada.
Yeah.
Yeah, she can.
Sorry, guys.
I'll take midsies. Hey, you come on this side. Show them the game that you play. Come on. Show them the game.
It's so dumb.
No, show them the game.
Dude, we're talking some zombie cafe here. It's good stuff. When we chill in the basement sometimes, he's playing Clash.
Or yeah, Clash.
PS4. I don't really play PS4.
Nah, he's not much of a gamer.
So, I just kind of watch and chill and play on my phone.
Which is nice.
Yeah.
We're going to f***ing Boondocks. Let's have some fun.
Here you go, Sweetums.
Thanks, babe.
You look good.
Thanks.
Just want to let you know.
Hopefully we're not the oldest people here. That's all I gotta say.
Okay, we're parents here, so.
I was not the
oldest
children. Oldest children. That's what I'm saying.
I'll be the oldest child in this place. Oh yeah, daddy.
See, it says fun.
Fun.
Center.
Oh, sorry. We're on camera.
Everyone smile and wave for us.
Smile and wave for us.
Hey,
thanks, Dazzle.
Thanks.
I got shoes! Oh, man. I'm like a kid
Yeah, man, I don't really
care. You want to do that?
Man, I want to go outside. like go-kart and stuff, man.
You want to?
What do you mean?
They look pretty slow.
I don't care. But it's go-kart.
There, yeah.
And I want to go mini-putting, so. I'm going to have unlimited fun.
The boys have finally arrived at the boondocks. And for the next 3 hours, they get to be kids. Or in Thomas Hargrave's position, he gets to act like himself.
Go around and swipe this where I want to.
Yeah, yeah, so you just swipe on any of the games.
We've never been. Like, we were here last year, but like, we came late, though.
So you just, any attractions on the outside, you're going to swipe your card. I'll get you a wristband.
Okay.
And this is just to show that you guys have the unlimited.
And the batting table is like the best one.
Bats and helmets are out there. You just swipe your card and you're good to go, man.
Excellent.
Same thing you got.
All right, let's do this.
To start their day of fun, a mini putt-putt match between Canadians and Americans, with nothing on the line but their nation's pride.
Tom, don't suck.
Oh, you can spin this and play. Like,
we have to spin this?
No, it's like for if you want to. So like spin it.
Man, why don't we just have a good game here?
I know. Let's see what I get. If you get a hole in one on this hole, put a zero on the scorecard.
Wow. Cool.
Kill.
Okay, I'll go third.
Well, who's hey guys, what's the score chart?
Bumps here.
Gravy, you're up.
Yeah.
I'm first.
Well, I just did it.
Hey, Gravy.
What's going on?
A second.
Watch this, baby.
Gotta practice. How's the wind?
Well, it's a pretty hot day in Ogden. And here goes Thomas on his first hole.
Lines up for the shot.
His first hole. Go ahead, please. Go ahead. Lines up for his first shot here. He's getting a hole in one, I can feel it. I don't
even
think
he's
gonna make it up the hill, mate. Oh, great shot, great shot, yeah.
Pretty good speed. From the shade. Wait.
So, yeah.
Chancellor Watson's.
This is gonna be a long round.
Oh, this is gonna be a long round.
Doesn't even make it up the hill.
Man.
Does it make
it? Might have been a Tom shot. That might have been worse than Tom's shot. But then
I like that.
Dorf, Dorf, DDD, Dorf.
Oh.
Oh, nice shot, my dude.
Oh, that's
shot.
A beaut.
That's a beaut.
That's a beaut. Let's go, Cali, baby.
Oh, that's big.
Oh, you're in the rough.
That was rough.
Oh, he's going this way.
Follow the leader.
Woo! Come on, Chaz. Come on.
Go in.
I'm a good coach.
Really dropping the ball for the boys today.
How?
A lovely kid, though.
That's a nice noodle.
Come on, Chaz. Whoa, that's money.
Go back.
That's a good place.
What happens if you make it
through an error?
That's so playable. So playable.
Hey, where it lies.
That was close. I almost took out my ankle.
Good game, fellas.
Great game, fellas.
Yeah.
Even after a final hole debacle by Dorfman, the Americans still beat the Canadians pretty handily.
Whatever.
I say we cart.
Yo, batting cages at some point?
Oh, yeah, I'm kind of batting cages now. You guys already.
Oh, it's only two bucks.
Good start, boys.
Press start and then the baseball.
Come on. I'll try it. Coming fast, man.
I know. They're a lot
oh
faster.
Oh my god. Oh. I'm actually getting angry at myself.
After going through an entire turn in the batting cages without hitting one ball, Watson concludes that Hargrave picked the right sport.
He's Canadian. We don't play baseball.
Man, like, that was actually insanely hard. Man, that was, like, insanely hard. You're trying to get a hit a ball.
I don't think, man, like, it doesn't appear.
Man, is there even an end on this?
Watson, on the other hand, has no problem connecting with the ball, and actually does quite well in the cage. After the batting cages, it is now time for the boys to hit the tracks. It doesn't take long for the boys to push the limits of the go-karts, and not even one full lap in, there's already a crash.
Attaboy, Brenda! Attaboy, Gravy! Ah! Are you kidding me?
Banks of bodies out there. I got a ton of gasoline in my eyes, I'll tell ya. You, Dorf.
After go-karts, the boys decide to go bowling.
What lane are we in? Where are we at? Time for some bowling.
Hockey players are known for their trash talk, and the pregame banter is full of "I'm better at bowling than you." But then once the game begins, everyone is able to see what's real and what's false bravado.
Nice little white weight ball.
Oh my gosh.
Man, come to cocky. Another cocky walk.
Yeah, came in cocky. Man, he's been letting down the team all day, baby.
I think I gotta hit one pin.
After a long, fun day at the Boondocks, the boys finally decide it's time to return home.
I'm trying to figure out what Canadian came up with the word A.
A?
A. Yeah, like, stupid.
After a quick pit stop at home, Watson persuades Hargrave to go work out with him, a decision Hargrave will soon regret.
The secret side of me, I never let you see. I keep it caged, but I can't control it. So stay away from me, the beast is ugly. I feel the rage and I just can't hold it. It's scratching on the walls, in the closet, in the halls. It comes awake and I can't control it. Hiding under the bed, in my body, in my head. Why won't somebody come and save me from this? Make it end. I feel it deep within. It's just been
See, Tom, I'm pretty glad we worked out.
No, that was not fun.
After their workout, the boys quickly return home for dinner and to hang out with Lucy.
I already shot eight boobs.
Did you?
Yeah.
She looks pretty happy.
No.
Oh, don't baby Lucy.
Hi, baby. Hello, baby.
This is the food.
Yeah.
What do we got, Dean?
Okay, we have pizza, we have pasta, we have beans, and we have hot dogs, and we got potatoes.
We're spoiled. Okay. That's spoiled.
So we have pretty much everything that you guys had during the week.
Yeah.
We're having leftovers tonight.
She took a pee on the car on the front carpet out there.
Oh, God. Uh-huh.
She took a pee on the front carpet out there.
Took a pee anywhere but where she's supposed to.
After dinner, Chandler Watson and Thomas Hargrave take turns reflecting on their day and anticipating the upcoming season.
It was a cool kind of day. It was cool actually walking around and having the camera there and having people ask you what it's for and telling them that you have this guy following you, seeing what your day-to-day life is like. It was good that we got a few of the boys out to get a good impression of what we do. We sometimes get a little rowdy and a little vulgar sometimes, but it's a lot of fun. I think juniors, one of the things, it's my last year of juniors, and one of the things I struggled with was planning out my last year or going straight to school, and a lot of the advice I got was that you can go to school anytime, but you can't play juniors forever. And so I'm really realizing that this being my last year, seeing all the guys and kind of being the highest guy on the totem pole, I'm learning to enjoy it. And so getting this little 24/7 of the day and getting documentation of me with the boys, and it's pretty cool. Yeah, it's been a lot of fun. Big thing about growing up in Thunder Bay, hockey town, every single winter when it froze over and got freezing nights, my dad would build a rink every year, so I'd be able to go home on breaks and skate out there. Our neighbors all knew he'd build a rink every winter, so they were all used to the pucks banging against the boards, and I just want to give him a shout out. My mom has always kind of helped me with the emotional aspect of the game. Hockey's a lot of mental stuff for me, so I think she's always been kind of the rock that I can call back after games and talk about that side with her, where my dad's always been the teach me to be the player who I am today. And I think him building a rink every single year, being out there at 1 a.m. flooding it, that's been a huge part of my life. So yeah, hockey's been probably brought me the best parts of my life, so it's been good. It's been a good journey. Yeah.
Honestly, just meeting the guys and just having such a brotherhood in the room and just having a brotherhood on the ice, like you make friends for the rest of your life. Like, me and Chan will be friends for the rest of our lives, and like Dazzo and I, like, you know, you just meet a lot of good buddies, and you know, you're just living the dream with the boys. I probably consider myself as one of the most serious guys on the team.
That's bullshit, buddy. Shut up, Tom.
Back home, we light and water up with the love. We wouldn't be here without you. This is for my people back home. Makes it